For several weeks, the village, and particularly the women of the cultural group Bukvitsa, have been preparing themselves to host a party of guests from America. The women are making a keepsake for each guest, a little bag filled with lavender grown in the nearby fields. Here is an opportunity to share with the outside world something of the culture and village way of life in Bukovlia that their forefathers would probably be familiar with. On the day itself, the men of the village, having previously hunted, prepared and marinated the meat, rise early to cook a special hunter's goulash for the guests and for the village as a whole. Our visitors today have come to Croatia on a genealogical tour that helps individuals track down living relatives and even the villages of their forefathers located right across the country. Each visitor is perhaps second, third or even fourth generation of a Croatian citizen who emigrated sometime in the 20th or late 19th century in search of better prospects abroad. Now their grandchildren and great-grandchildren are returning. They are following a trail back in time that will lead them to a part of the country that they can call home. This sense of home arouses powerful emotions that seem impossible to articulate in words. There are forces at work that compel the individual to travel great distances in pursuit of any clue that might bring them a step closer to finding the source of their origins. A journey, the searching for and the prospect of finding family members in their ancestral village, is highly intoxicating. And the making of a connection with the earth where once their families were rooted can have a profound effect on the individual.
And to say how grateful we are to Mr. Robert for choosing our little village to host his group. I'd also like to welcome our special guests from America, as well as the members of the Kud Izvor, the firemen of DVD Bukovlje, the hunters of Lovačko društvo Brezetinac, and the villagers. First we will see the performance of Kud Izvor. Then the lunch will be served in the firehouse. We prepared a meal called goulash for the rest of the guests, but if anyone wants to try some, please say so. After lunch, the band from the Kud will play and you can dance if you want to. I hope everyone enjoys the festivities, and if you have any questions, feel free to ask me or Mr. and Mrs. Norris.
These experiences are deeply personal, but the understanding of their significance is something that the group as a whole can share, that feeling of belonging. What are your impressions of the village here?
My impression is absolutely wonderful. I'm back home to my roots.
You feel that?
I do indeed. Mm-hmm. The first time we came to Croatia with my mother, we came home, I could not explain to my husband the feeling that I had when we got to the property that was my father's homeland. Mm.
Emotional, but yeah, I belong here, you know. It's something that's part of me, you know.
So what does it mean for you to come to a village like this?
Just a wonderful experience. Just unbelievable. Very emotional.
Do you imagine it's like the villages of your ancestors?
Yeah. That's what I think of it as. Just unbelievable. I never thought I'd have the opportunity.
You're feeling at home in Croatia?
Yes. Yeah. Everything that I see in the people that were strongest in my family is played out in how these people
are.
We enjoyed the Bora, and you know, we've been through a lot together. It's been kind of cozy, and you know, we've talked about this event here for, you know, weeks in the emails, and today we talked a little bit more about it. And we have to stop. You know, I said about celebrating our culture and honoring our ancestors, and the group has been very generous with the donation for the Ženska udruga Bukvica, which is the ladies' cultural club. And again, their goal is to buy a loom to make the cloth, the traditional cloth. So I'd like to present this to the group on behalf of them.
Okay, my name is Paulette Johnson. I hesitate because I feel like my name is now Pavlo Rupčić. But I didn't know that when I started this. And when I came to Croatia because I never knew my Croatian background, and I've been looking for 20 years. And all I knew was that my grandfather was named Joseph Rubik, and he was from Croatia. And that's all I knew a month ago. So I made up this flyer. I don't know if you can see it. Mm-hmm. I started writing a blog about trying to find my grandfather and my Croatian relatives, and I said in it, I can't find them, they're going to have to find me. And that's kind of what happened when I came here. So basically, when I came here, I just Googled Rupčić, and I made a hotel reservation at any place that had Rupčić in the title. And so the first place was near Plitvice Lakes. But the second place was in Zaga. And by then, Robert Jaron had told me, you know, you should be looking around Zaga. So I got an email from some strange woman saying, I was looking on Ancestry and I saw that you're looking for Joseph Rubik and you should look in Zaga. And I wrote her back and I said, well, that's funny because I'm staying there with Ivan Rupčić. She goes, well, that's odd because that's my brother-in-law. So we get to Zagan, and I get an email from a Croatian genealogist saying, I think I know where your grandfather's from. I think he might be from Zagan, and this is his birthday. So I had this one picture of him. So we came, and we're staying with Ivan Rupčić, who happens to be Hare Krishna. Which was, what am I doing here in this village? And he takes us up to Kal, the small village where they think this Joseph Rupčić is from. And we're looking around and we look at the village and we leave. And we happen to see a thing on the wall that says the partisan World War II losses. And they listed Nikola Rupčić, same father as the Joseph Rupčić she found. Rupčić. So Ivan knew everybody in town, and so he hooked me up with these two women who are from that lineage. And I was showing my picture, and I was saying, this is a picture of my grandfather who came to America 100 years ago. And they said, you know, 60 years ago I saw a picture like that, but he was sitting down. And then they were arguing with each other in Croatian, and maybe, maybe not, maybe not. Meanwhile, we go to the records office, and they have the birth records of Joseph Rupčić and my grandmother. So then Ivan takes us to this man in town who is a 96-year-old genealogist, and he has the family history of everybody in the entire Novi Vinodolski. And it laid out everybody. It said Joseph Rupčić. It stops. So that means he went to America. So the two cousins invited me over. I walk in the house, and they said, we have to show you something. And I go over to the table, and there on the table is a picture of my... there. They found the picture of my grandfather that had been sent them 60 years ago. And they turned it over, and it said, in memory of Joseph Rubik, who went to America.
Wow.
And that's, you know, my brother died, my father died, and I just felt... I wanted to feel my heart on the ground. Mm. I wanted to feel my heart in the ground of the homeland. And that's kind of what happened.
Fantastic.
You know, it was so... every day something happened that was a miracle. And like we told Ivan we'd like to hear Klapa music, and so he set up a private Klapa music concert. And one of the players said, you know, that town you're from, people are trying to preserve the culture. And it's just like this. It's a little town, wonderful people, everything. So we get an invitation to a barbecue up there, and it turns out that it's my cousin, and he lives next door, and he shows us the house where my grandfather was born. And they're showing me the dances and the songs from 200-300 years ago, just by chance.
Yeah.
You know?
Mm-hmm. So what does it mean for you to come to a vintage like this?
It's like going home, you know, and I can't understand it. It's, you know, I'm trying to think, what is it that you connect to so much, that moves you so much, you know? I'm thinking at home, you have your grandma, and that's about it. And that's about as far as you go back. Mm. But when you come here, there's something so, it's like my family and my people have always existed. Mm. I just didn't know where they were. You know, I didn't know where they were, and they've been here waiting for me all
this
time.
They found them, yeah. Well, they found you.
I said, they found me.
Yeah.
You know, so when we just left Yvonne's house yesterday, and he was always doling out little pieces of the story for us. You know, he wouldn't
piece by piece.
He would. He said, "You must wait. You have to be patient. You must wait." And like I have a week into staying there, he says, oh, right across the street here, that's where your grandfather went to church. So we were leaving yesterday, and he says, I have a gift for you. I have something for you. And he raises cows.
Mm-hmm.
So he gives me a machete, and he says, come with me. And I'm like, what is he going to do? And he takes a straw bale, and he cuts it in a piece off of it, and he gives me the string, and then he gives me a key to the house. Now I have the keys to the house. And I don't want to leave.
Yeah. While the village of Pukovlje, like all villages, has certainly changed over the years, there is undoubtedly a spirit that has survived. It is a spirit of community that is rooted in the land and still finds expression in the people the music, and the locally inspired folk art practiced in the village. It is a spirit that has endured for centuries.